while. I am going on a cruise, and if you can hear my laundry machine in the background, it's because I'm drying my clothes right now so I can pack. I am just starting to pack for my cruise to Alaska. And if you're asking why I'm going to Alaska as a 24-year-old on a cruise, my parents want to go, and so my grandparents. So we're doing a whole family vacation. If I had a choice in vacation, it would not be an Alaskan cruise, but we are going and it is family time, so it'll be fun. Let's start packing.
Summer rain on a window. Watch the time float on. Cool air blows a memento.
Hey, here is the hotel room. It's two twin beds that they put together to be one. There is the bathroom. It is just a sink, that's me, and then a shower. A fun fact is that they have 2-in-1 hair and body wash instead of, you know, separating it out. So that's fun. There's no lotion, which is something I didn't think about. A TV, and then here's my brother's suitcase. And then there's a couch in here. And then that's the book I'm currently reading. And then that's my outfit. And then there's a balcony that my brother and I. Okay, here's me struggling to open said, oh, it's a slide. I'm an idiot. Yep, that's the balcony. That's the horn. And I got an obstructed view, which means basically our view is obstructed 50%. My parents and my grandparents got a non-obstructed view. But that's just what happens. So here's the thing, two detriments to this cruise so far. The first is I forgot my hydro flask. And it's typically not that big of a deal, or I didn't think it was gonna be that big of a deal, but the only way that you can get water is if you get like a glass of water. And that is just inconvenient. And like when we're walking around, that's not the best. So my family brought a water bottle and we're just gonna use that and refill it. Along with the water hydro flask being forgotten, I always keep my scrunchie around my hydro, and because I forgot my hydro flask, I also forgot a scrunchie. But I have this clip, and that's gonna have to do for now. The second detriment, which actually hurts a little harder, is I forgot my AirPods. Moment of silence. I have my wired headphones, because I was like, oh, it's fine, because I always keep my wired headphones in my fanny pack, so I have that. And I checked while we were waiting. I don't have a dongle. So that's my life. My brother has a dongle, so maybe I'll just use that. Typically, I'm pretty good about packing and stuff, but I feel like because today was just kind of hectic with packing, I didn't. Today was a lot of just getting our bearings, figuring everything out. We watched a show today that was pretty decent. And now I'm just going to read and relax and brush my teeth.
As I fall behind, I'm so sorry for dreaming about the future.
It's currently day 2. Oh my gosh. If you're wondering what's on my finger, it is I pinched my middle finger in my tripod stand when I was filming a different video. And then this happened. Anyway, so it's day 2. Minor inconvenience of the day is that my clip that I brought broke. And so now, the only other sturdy hair thing that I had for this trip, gone. So, it's fun. I told my family, I was like, I'm one minor inconvenience away from a breakdown. And those are true statements. But I am currently in bed. It's like almost 3 o'clock, but I'm just so tired today, and I feel like the water is really getting to my brain now.
Today so far, we've had a sexiest man competition, and while that sounds fun, it was very funny. Some guy ripped his shirt, and I was like, damn, go off. Some guy attempted the splits, and I was like, wow, this is what a cruise is like, because it's very much like middle-aged demographic, and I am not middle-aged, but I am a boomer in my brain. Boop, there's that. And then tonight it's like dress up night, so we'll see.
Take apart all the good things, stripped away what's there to do.
Just on my hot girl walk, and I felt a mist, and then I was like, wow, how refreshing. And then I looked down at my shirt, and then I just saw oil stains on my nice white sweatshirt.
And also my Lainey t-shirt. This is the small inconvenience that is gonna send me over the edge. But I am vlogging in public, but not super public. I'm just in the back row, just vlogging. Anyway, I am really upset about the shirt, like genuinely. It's a concert tee. And I love this t-shirt. After I got sprayed with oil, I went back to the room and tried to wash it off, and it didn't wash off. So now I don't know what to do. And I can't Google it because there's no service. I am stuck. Now I'm sitting and reading because apparently being outside is just not good for me. And so I literally am like, I don't know what to do now because my shirt's ruined. I'm just gonna hope it washes off when I get home.
Day 4.
I walked in and I saw this and I said, hey look, an aardvark. It's a bunny. It's almost 11 and that means it's past my bedtime. To give y'all a quick little update on my day, nothing really incredibly exciting happened, as you can imagine, since I'm in Alaska. Sorry if you live in Alaska, that's not a dig against your state. It's a dig against my personality. So today we really just walked around Skagway. Sorry, Alaskans, I don't mean to offend you or your state or your cities. Yeah, so we just walked around, went on this nice little boat ride. Well, we didn't technically own a boat ride. I'm technically on a boat ride right now. We took a little train ride. If you're interested in my cruise love life, I don't understand why you would be, because there is no cruise love life. I said this to my brother yesterday. When we were in the city that we were in yesterday, we saw this guy working at one of the like touristy shops. And after I left, I was like, that cashier was the best thing I've seen all day. And at the end of the day, still rang true. My mom was like, he has really pretty eyelashes. My brother was like, I can't look at him. And I was like, you know what? Neither can I. Because he was just too pretty. Yeah, cross your fingers for me to find the love of my life on this cruise and have that be a cute little meet cute. But we were at this game show today that was called Love and Marriage. And it's basically like they have three couples, one a newlywed, one like 10 to 25 years wed, and then like one above 40 years married. And the show was basically like, let's ask them questions and see if their answers match. And the newlywed couple met on a cruise. They were 15 when they met on the cruise. And apparently, the guy slept with all of the girls at said cruise. I don't want that to be my love life. You know, I wouldn't complain about finding a man on this cruise if only, even if only for the next couple of days. So far, no luck. As I've been surrounded by my family, my parents, my brother, my grandparents, my aunt, my uncle, this whole time. That was my little update, which is basically just saying no updates. Keep you all posted to see if I find the love of my life. Currently rereading Love in Other Words because I was like, that is a perfect book to read on a cruise because it's summer vibes. It's cute. I know that I'm gonna love it. And now I'm annotating it because that's how much I like it. I read it beginning of this year. And then I was like, wow, this is a 5-star read for me. I want to reread it. So I reread it, or I'm rereading it now. And I have like this much left. I'm still reading Conversations on Love. I feel like that's a brain book, and my brain is in booking right now. Hotel on Nantucket, something like that. And I might read that next because I also heard that's a summer book. Hello, it is day 5 of the cruise. As an update of my day, I didn't really do much. I went to a silent party. We walked around Juno. I got my bank account hacked into. Yeah, just a normal day in the life. Like I said at the beginning of the vlog, like, oh, one more minor inconvenience and I'm breaking down and the world, it's not a challenge. Please stop. Like, just relax. For a little bit. I don't need any more inconveniences in my life. So yeah, that was a fun revelation today. I checked my email in the morning. Good, thank God I had service today because the charge happened yesterday, which I was okay. So I got an email from Mint, and if you don't have Mint, it's not sponsored, but it's a great little tool to keep track of your finances, and that's what I do, and it was very helpful in this case of alerting me that I had unrecognized charges in a large amount. And I was like, what the hell is going on? Like, I'm on vacation. And the thing is, if it was my credit card, it'd be one thing, because maybe that's facts, you know, I'm a spender. But because it was from my savings account, I was like, this is not good. So I checked my savings account and I was like, there were a couple of charges over $1,000. And I was like, it wasn't me. I was looking at it and it said like it was a PayPal or something, and I was like, no, I don't think that was me. And like I said, I'm very appreciative that we were on land today so I can make this phone call to my bank. So I called my bank and I was like, hey, I don't recognize these charges. What are they? And they're like, oh, we can't, like, we don't have any more information. It was made directly with PayPal. It looks like they got your routing number and your bank account information. And I was like, okay, so it's just this account. It's not like my whole bank thing, because that would be a bigger issue. And they're like, yeah, it seems like it's just account, but I would keep an eye on it on your other accounts to make sure that they weren't affected as well. And I was like, okay, that I can do. was thinking like, hey, maybe I should send Mint a friendly worded letter saying like, thank you for helping me catch some fraudulent charges on my bank account. So I checked it and like, I'm gonna get the money back, but apparently hackers tried to transfer a couple of other larger sums, but thank God I'm broke because they tried to transfer more money than $1,000 and they couldn't because I had not enough money in my bank account. And that is on me for not having money, baby. And at the end of the call, the man says, I hope you have a good weekend and I hope you enjoy the rest of your vacation. And I said, you too. And then I paused. And I said, just kidding, I hope you have a good weekend. And then I hung up. Yeah, that was the, you know, how I started my day. Always starting with good things of the hush party because I had such a blast just watching people. Really creepy. It is really creepy. But like, because it's headphones and like when you take your headphones off, collective effort from everybody to be a part of this thing. Date on my finger, if y'all want to see it. Every time I look at it, I always think it's a mole on my finger and I really don't appreciate it being there. So this book is now complete. It's for our second time this year and I did annotate it and I'll give you a quick little flip. You can't even see any of my annotations. I have some highlights, I have some underlines, I have some little words. Time to go swimming! I just brushed my teeth and I'm now getting ready for bed. I have mice on my shirt and I don't know why, but it has brought me quite a amount of joy to be saying that throughout the day. And that is the excitement of my life. Anyway, today was a relatively relaxing day. I really just walked around finding different places to read. And to update you, as you probably see in the clips that I had previously taken, I started reading The Hotel Nantucket. And I've put a pause on reading Conversations on Love because this morning I saw someone reading something that looked like The Hotel Nantucket and I was like, that's a sign. I'll just do it. And I'm like 100 pages in, which is on pretty quick for me for a day. Like I'm a pretty slow reader. I would say medium speed. I'm like a decent amount of the way in and I like it so far. But yeah, that's basically what I did today. Nothing super exciting. We were cruising the whole day. Tomorrow we're stopping in Victoria, British Columbia. That was my quick little update. Another day where I did not find a cruise love. And honestly, at this point, I do not think I'm going to find a cruise love. I am now back home and I unpacked, yay on me, instead of just leaving everything in my suitcase and then using the clothes and then after it gets to a abysmal amount, then unpacking. And now I'm just going to relax. I honestly still feel like I'm on a boat, like I'm a little rocky, but that's what I get for being on a cruise for 7 days. I want to thank you all for coming along on this voyage with me. And watching me live my sweet life on deck. I ate a lot. I had more fun than I thought I was going to. Yeah, that's it. I will see you all in the next vlog. My name is Carrot Talks and you're watching Disney Channel. Bye!